It's always amazing how someone who is doing their own thing wants to start interfering with what you're doing in everything. What I mean is that individual who's trying to allegedly help you might actually be a hindrance to you if they've got some controls over you already. But when you get a new opportunity, your best bet is to save it completely and privately for yourself. Because the minute you start talking and brainstorming about what it could be, what it might be, what it won't be, what it shouldn't be, what it should be, you start to taint yourself. Anytime you involve someone outside of God's plan, you might find yourself getting further and further off track to what God has for you that can be so prosperous and so performing and so opportunistic for you that you miss it all. You see, there's a lot of people that want to slow you down on the road or the race of life when God wants to blast you off as a superhero in the night. In America, human beings have privacy rights. I've been talking about this a lot because I really want the politicians of the world to get this. The human being owns the rights to every part of their life. The human being, the individual, owns the rights to their entire body, their entire being. The human being owns the rights to all of their legal records, all their documentation. It belongs to the individual. At no time does anyone outside of that space have any right to interfere with the creation of that place. And openly, the individual is fully accountable, fully amenable, fully participating in the ownership of their own possessions. Possessions are pretty straightforward. Those are things that person has purchased, things that person has given, been given, things that person has received as presents over time, things that person has found, maybe like a gold mine. But it doesn't matter. What matters is that person's ownership. You own nothing in someone else's life, unless, of course, you're married to them or you're the legal heir of them.